Hi, this is Dave from Steel City Jones Flight Academy, and we are at our brand new training facility in Fort Myers, Florida, and we are testing a lot of equipment down here. So this episode is regarding the Phantom 4 Pro RTK system, brand new, just released, and we are going to go over a lot of the features, the functionality of this system. And I want to also introduce to you Michael McVeigh, who is part of Florida Drone Supplies. And Florida Drone Supply is our premier equipment vendor for everything drones. So Michael is selling all this stuff as well as supporting it. And together we are lining up with training down here in Florida for a lot of different things. The mapping is included in that. But you know, let's get right to it, Michael. Okay. You know, this really is, this aircraft is making a big buzz in the industry right now. You know, for the past 2-3 years, ever since the M600 first came out, the RTK system, everybody has been asking, do we need ground control? Do we need ground control? Do we need ground control? And now, and always the answer has been, yes, you do. Yes, you do, even with an RTK system. So now what's really interesting is that now DJI is coming out and saying that you can get up to 3 centimeters of accuracy with no ground control. So that's, and obviously that's making the entire industry going nuts. And people are buying this system sight unseen, you know, and they're just going ahead and going all out for it. Why don't you talk about some of the, actually, and some of the new features that are just coming out with this system as far as networking capability?
Absolutely, happy to do that. And you're definitely right that this is really what people have been waiting for. The M600 RTK and then the M210 RTK. We all wanted to get a system that didn't require ground control points, and this seems to be the answer that all of our surveyors and professional mappers have been waiting for. Built into the Phantom is this new high precision RTK system. This is the most highest precision RTK system that DJI's had yet. It transfers the most data and streaming error correction from the ground control system to embed that right into your pictures. And there's actually a couple different ways that you can do your RTK processing. You can either do it through the RTK station now, which will give us very, very good accuracy, or we can do PPK, which is post-processing on our satellite data.
Right off the bat, you know, the first thing that we noticed with the ground station is that it takes a crystal sky battery, and so does the remote now. So everything is now going crystal sky batteries. It's very nice to see a universal battery across the board for all the accessories, which is great.
This has been another thing where DJI is really listening to their professional customers that have asked for battery consistency and battery uniformity. So they use it on their crystal sky monitors, they can use it in their ground station, they can use it in the new remote controller, the remotes. It's been a great thing to get battery uniformity.
One of the first things we did when we started testing this aircraft was a wind test. Luckily, we had some pretty significant wind for us to test, and where you can see the palm trees bending. The Phantom 4 Pro RTK held up extremely well and better than expected. We didn't see more than a 3-4 inch drop in altitude in 30 mile an hour wind gusts, which is incredible for a drone its size and weight. For this test, we put a standard Phantom 4 Pro V2 next to the Phantom 4 Pro RTK to show the drastic difference in wind performance. The regular P4 Pro dropped about 7 feet in altitude, which is very typical for a consumer grade drone. The RTK version held solid in both height and position. The wind performance alone of this aircraft will significantly improve survey accuracy on the Z-axis.
Before we actually get into the mapping accuracy and everything, let's talk about the camera. Yeah. So basically it's a 20 megapixel camera. It's the same thing basically as the X4S camera, and or also the same camera that you have on the regular Phantom 4 Pro. So the very first thing that jumped out at me, when we did a flight at 200 feet, we really didn't like how soft it was. Yeah. You know, it was a bit soft and the resolution really wasn't as to our liking. I guess if you're doing boundary surveys, or you know, you're not needing to do a project that needs a lot of really high resolution, then it's not a big deal. But let's talk a little bit about the trade-off, the pros and the cons with using a camera like this versus the Matrice 210 RTK with the X5S camera. You know, there's a lot of people, you know, when I talk to many people, they say, I won't use it, rolling shutter. But, you know, there are things that, you know, the X5S, in my opinion, is a little better for certain applications. So would you like to talk a little bit about how, you know, what kind of shutters are in both aircraft, in both cameras, and why maybe the Matrice 200, 210 RTK system might be a better application for some of that mapping?
So first of all, it does look very much like a P4 Pro camera. It is limited in the fact that you can't change the aperture. So as we're planning our mapping missions, we do have to keep that in mind, that we don't have aperture control like we do with some other cameras. And then we've got the issue of the different shutter types. So we have either a mechanical shutter, a global shutter, or we have a rolling shutter. This has the mechanical shutter, which means it opens and closes very uniform. It exposes the whole sensor all at one time, so we don't have the shutter opening and closing, and we get that gap between when the bottom is exposed and when the top is exposed. So that some surveyors are concerned about that, mappers are concerned about that, and they say, well, can we use the X5S? Well, if you have an aircraft that'll fly with the X5S, you can definitely overcome some of the issues that the rolling shutter causes.
Yep.
Because you could change your flight speed, you could change your...
Slow it down.
You could slow your flight down, you could change your aperture, you could make sure you get a real fast shutter speed so that opening closing time is very quick.
Yes.
And if you're not moving very fast, you're still going to get that real crisp, clear picture, as well as you have the ability to change your GSD or ground sampling distance, which shows how much clarity that you'll have on the ground per pixel. With this, you're limited because you can't change lenses.
Yes.
With an X5S, you could go higher, change lenses, and get a smaller, tighter ground sampling distance. So there's trade-offs to both.
Right.
On the subject of the GS-RTK app, let's talk a little bit about how it works. To create a mission, you can create a flight plan anywhere without having to be on site. Once you create it, you can save it and then recall it anytime you want to fly. You can also import KML pre-programmed flight files.
Okay, everybody, let's talk about the base station that comes with the Phantom 4 Pro RTK for a second. So, again, this is a very nice piece. I think that did a very nice actual improvement over the Matrice 210 RTK system for what you get, because you only get the actual very small base station. So, a little bit of review here. What we have is the actual the base station itself is two pieces. It actually will unscrew right here. So this is one port, this is the top part of it. And then this is the dowel pin, which is all one piece right there. And at the very bottom is a very nice little tip. You can very easily put a very finite point and use a cord, actually reference the base station to a reference point that will make that all tie it together in for higher accuracy. Carbon fiber here, this is very nice. This is for, also can be used as a potentially as a rover. There's three different modes that the base station can be used as. We're just using it right now as a portable station. Now, some functionality that's not available yet is right over here. Inside here, you can put a 4G dongle inside here with a SIM card so that we can actually set up a end trip network to the base station. Then that would be nice as well. But right now that's not a function that's activated. I'm not sure how long that will take. Last part of this is the actual tripod itself. When we first opened the box, we said, wow, this is a really nice survey grade quality type of tripod. But as we got a little more into it, we noticed that there's no way the legs lock in. So that's a problem. We think if you, this, you know, there's really, this can get easily bumped. Not really liking that too much. Now, on the tripod itself is a bubble level, and actually right here is another bubble level that'll help you make sure that the ground, the base station is perfectly level, which is really good.
We get a lot of questions about what RTK technology can do, and many people misunderstand the technology, so we want to take a second to clarify a few things. this aircraft will work very well around high concentrations of metal and high voltage EMI environments. However, you still need to be very careful around cell towers that use microwave dish emitters for backhaul. RTK technology can't prevent high power backhaul to interfere between the control signal between the drone and the remote controller.
So now that we talked about some of the new features and functionality of what this aircraft can do, let's talk about some of the limitations and things that we quite didn't like the most about this aircraft. I'll come out on and preface out by saying, we recognize that this is a first generation aircraft and it's only going to get better. But I'm a little disappointed. I think that it should have been tested just a little bit more, Michael, because I'm going to have you talk about, there's been a lot of bonky issues that we've had to overcome. You want to talk about some of the things with the app?
Yeah, sure. Well, to start with, you have no choice but to use the GSRTK app. And we have some people that would have liked to have seen some options with that. It's built into the screen. We have to use it. And we've had some issues with it, crashing during flight plans. We've had some trouble with it, requiring numerous updates over the past month or so. And just trying to get everything to connect and work properly has been a little bit flaky.
Exactly. My number one pet peeve with this is them forcing us to use the small version touchpad of the built-in Crystal Sky monitor,
right.
Essentially.
Right.
It's essentially the same monitor as the Phantom 4 Pro Plus. And I find that very hard to use. I've had to bite my tongue several times because I just can't get the thing to touch very well. It's small. And I mean, everybody that we talked to so far that's used this, they say the same thing. And at least at a very minimum, let us use an iPad or let us have a USB out so that we can actually use an external source. They're not allowing us to be able to do any of that. And I'm sure that's going to be changed and improved with time. But right now, that's a little bit of an issue.
Yeah. And, this could change obviously in the future too. But as of now, when our clients are trying to import the KML files into a mapping project, it's not letting them do that without having a paid subscription to a service like that.
So like I said, we recognize that there's growing pains with first generation platforms and no aircraft. And there's not one aircraft that we've ever tested that we can come out and say, this really has done everything that we like it to do. So, and again, we're not trying to put this aircraft down. We want to give you, because we think it has definitely a huge market in here. But some of the things that, we just like to make sure that we carefully weigh the really good things that it does and some of the limitations that it does so that you can go ahead and draw your own conclusions as to whether or not you think that this is, at this moment, the right fit for you. Michael, do you have anything to add?
Well, I think what you said at the end was just perfect at this moment, because we've all seen the manufacturer DJI release a new aircraft and then continue to add feature sets to it and continue to add support for the things that don't work out of the box. And we really have our fingers crossed that will be the case here, and this will continue to be a much improved aircraft for all the people that are considering it.
Now, let's get to the real meat of this video, which is testing this gear and finding out exactly where it stands. So we're planning on doing 4 tests in our new training center. Really nice wide open area, great training facility. We're going to map the whole area. And then we're going to do is we're going to fly the Phantom 4 Pro RTK system with the RTK enabled, and we have ground control laid down. So then what we're going to do is process that same flight without the ground control to see what happens, what the difference is without any ground control. Yep. We're trying to do everything exactly the same. We're being very scientific about this. We're doing it in the same day, the same time. So with that said, we're going to get up in the air, do the tests, and then we're going to come back and review them.
For the mapping tests, we measured 4 checkpoints taken with survey-grade equipment, strategically placed throughout the flown location. We also laid out 4 traditional ground control points for post-processing, like shown here. When evaluating any mapping data, it is important to understand there's a number of input variables entered into PIX4D that can easily influence the project accuracy reports. In our opinion, the only way to verify the accuracy of the collected data is to compare it to known reference points. So the check shots were critical to evaluating our data. While this is not a mapping class, it's also important to understand there's a wide variety of factors that can influence the accuracy of any project. So the results we achieved may vary from what another drone operator experiences. So now let's talk about the results. How does DJI's claim of 3 to 5 centimeters of accuracy using NTRIP without ground control points stack up? Our test results were extremely accurate and produced results better than we would have ever expected. Absolute horizontal accuracy came in within 1.7 centimeters, and vertical accuracy on the Z-axis came in less than 1 centimeter. Most drones actually have a higher degree of error on the Z-axis because the aircraft's flight path normally has more altitude variance, which goes to show how tight RTK keeps the flight path. Again, our results were tested against 8 different checkpoints to validate the data. Adding in 4 ground control points to the PIX4D project brought the overall accuracy in even tighter. Absolute accuracy was less than 1 centimeter, and relative accuracy came in no higher than 1.75 centimeters. To conclude, we want to point out that while the Phantom 4 Pro RTK is a great tool to acquire data, it is not a substitute or replacement for traditional survey equipment or methods. There's no possible way to validate data that a drone acquires without having known accurate data to double-check it against.
Okay, so those are the results. So if you are impressed with those results, I can tell you that, you know, Michael is definitely the source to go to, and we are obviously offering that through our Flight Academy and through Michael as well. Everything's going through Florida Drone Supplies. And if you also, in addition to the equipment, you need training on any of this, on how to do the mapping, how to use the ground control, the post-processing as well. You know, down in here, Steel City Flight Academy, in conjunction with Florida Drone Supply, also has really good modified version of precision agriculture for golf course management training that we're doing down here as well. So, you know, that's another area, that's another market that's really picking up, and, you know, we do that as well too. So on the training side, we got you covered. On the equipment side, we got you covered. So I want to thank you again, Michael, for all your time. And if you have any questions, guys, please reach out to us, and thanks for watching.
Thank you.